Now we will study the process of voltage buildup in case of DC shunt generator and its critical resistance and critical speed. Now you know that in this DC shunt generator, field winding F1, F2, it is connected in parallel with armature A1, A2. And it is self-excited generator, means the field winding is excited by the EMF induced across armature itself. Now initially when the machine is started, means when the armature is rotated at rated speed, EMF induced in armature will be equal to zero because the current through field winding is also equal to zero. So if there is no field current, there will not be flux. And if there is no flux, there is no induced EMF EG. And therefore, EG will remain zero. So here the question is, how we get the rated voltage EG across the terminals of armature whenever the shunt generator is started. So let us now see the process of voltage buildup in case of DC shunt generator. Now here the line OP, this line OP, it represents the resistance of this field winding circuit, that is RSH. Now here on the Y axis there is voltage across field winding, and on X axis there is current through field winding, and therefore slope of this line OP will be equal to the voltage divided by current, which is nothing but resistance RSH. And therefore if the slope of this line OP is equal to resistance of the field winding RSH, then this line OP represents the resistance of shunt field winding. Now in shunt generators, when we start the machine, this armature is rotated at constant rated speed. Now that time EMF induced in generator is not equal to zero. This is because of residual magnetism present. So you know that this open circuit characteristic, it starts from point A and not from point O. Means at this point the field current is equal to zero. Even if the field current is equal to zero, EMF induced in armature is not equal to zero. It is equal to OA. And this EMF is because of residual magnetic flux. Now because of this EMF OA, this EMF OA will circulate current through the field winding, because this EMF OA is available across these two terminals A1, A2, and this EMF will circulate current IF. Now current circulated by this EMF OA is equal to field current OB. So current in field winding will increase from 0 to OB. And because of this current OB, this field winding will produce additional flux. Now, if the additional flux is in the same direction as that of the residual flux, resultant flux will increase. And because of increased flux, there is increase in the induced EMF. And therefore this current OB creates flux which supports the residual flux, and hence larger EMF will be produced, and EMF produced by this current OB in the field winding will be EMF OC. Now this OC is available across armature. Now because of OC, current through field winding will further increase to OD. And this increased current OD will induce more EMF in armature. So this will continue the current through field winding goes on increasing and the EMF induced also goes on increasing. And finally, the point of intersection, that is P. P is the point of intersection between this OCC and the straight line OP, which represents shunt field winding. So finally, the output will be steady at this point, and here the EMF generated will be EG. So this is how the voltage in case of DC shunt generator will build up. Here, for explanation purpose, the build-up process is shown in discrete steps. However, in practice, very quickly the EMF generated will increase from A to this point P. That means EMF induced will increase from this OA to OEG, and finally the voltage across armature will be EG, which is the no load terminal voltage across armature. Now the EMF generated by the armature EG will circulate current IF in the field winding, and the resistance of field winding is RSH, and therefore EG must be equal to IF into RSH. However, there is one more factor, which is the opposing EMF induced in this coil whenever the current through the coil changes. So the EMF induced in this coil, it is LdIFdt, and this induced EMF opposes the generated voltage EG, and therefore the EMF EG has to first supply the ohmic drop in field winding, that is IF into RSH. In addition to that, this EG has to overcome the opposing self-induced EMF in the field coil, that is LdIFdt. Means actually EG is equal to IFRSH plus LdIFdt. So if EG is greater than this IFRSH, so if EG is greater than the ohmic drop IFRSH, then the remaining energy will be stored in the field poles. Whereas if EG is equal to IFRSH, then energy cannot be stored in the field poles. So here, for example, suppose the field current is OA. Now this field current will produce the generated voltage, which is equal to AC. Now out of this AC, this AB will supply the ohmic drop, that is IFRSH. Means AB will supply IFRSH, whereas remaining EMF BC will overcome the self-induced EMF in the field coil, that is LdIFdt. So AB supplies ohmic drop and BC overcomes the self-induced EMF in the coil, and therefore some energy is stored in the field poles. Now let us consider the field current OD. Now if the field current is OD, the generated EMF will be OE. Now this entire EMF OE is required to supply the ohmic voltage drop, that is IF into RSH, and nothing is left to overcome the self-induced EMF in the field coil, that is LdIFdt. So in this case, generated EMF EG is not greater than the ohmic drop IF into RSH, and therefore the energy will not be stored in the field poles. And because of that, from this point onwards, field current and hence generated EMF will not increase. Means the maximum EMF that can be obtained with this value of field resistance RSH is OE. And this operating point is always represented by the point of intersection of the open circuit characteristic and the shunt field resistance line. So the maximum EMF that can be obtained with this resistance line OP is OE. Now we have seen that the point of operation is the point of intersection of the open circuit characteristic and shunt field resistance line. So in this case, the generated EMF is equal to E. Now if the shunt field resistance is reduced, let us see what happens. So if shunt field resistance is reduced, slope of this resistance line will also reduce. And therefore, the reduced resistance can be represented by line OQ. Now the operating point will be this point Q. And for this point Q, somewhat higher generated EMF can be obtained. Whereas if the shunt field resistance is slightly increased, then the slope of resistance line will also increase. So that increased resistance line, it is represented by this line OR. Now in this case, R is the point of intersection and therefore the generated EMF will be slightly less than the original value. So in case of DC shunt generator, if shunt field resistance is reduced, generated EMF will increase. On the other hand, if shunt field resistance is increased, generated EMF will decrease. Now, if the resistance is increased further and if shunt field resistance is very large, then it can be represented by this line OS. Now, in this case, we can see that this line will not intersect the open circuit characteristic and therefore there will not be any operating point. And therefore, in this case, the generator will fail to excite. Means voltage buildup in case of DC shunt generator is not possible if shunt field resistance is very high. So let us now see the case when the shunt field winding resistance is RC. And the resistance line is such that it lies just along the slope of this open circuit characteristic. So with this value of shunt field resistance, that is RC, the machine will just excite. So the value of shunt field winding resistance, which is represented by the tangent to the OCC, is known as critical resistance RC for a given speed. So this RC represents the critical resistance of shunt generator. If value of shunt field winding is greater than RC, then the machine will fail to excite. And if the value of shunt field resistance is equal to RC, the machine will just excite. Now to calculate the value of critical resistance RC, we have to first plot the open circuit characteristic. And then we have to draw a line which is tangent to the initial portion of this open circuit characteristic. The slope of this line is nothing but the resistance RC, and which is known as critical resistance, and it is the critical resistance of DC shunt generator for the speed at which this open circuit characteristic is plotted. We know that the generated EMF EG depends on flux phi and speed n. If phi is constant, EG is proportional to n. Now, in this magnetization curve, the point from which this curve bends, we call it as knee of the magnetization curve. And the operating point is always after the knee of the magnetization curve. Here, with field resistance RSH, the operating point is P, and corresponding is the generated EMF EG. Now, if the speed of armature is reduced, then we will get the open circuit characteristic shown by curve 3. So, in this case, this speed N2 is very less than speed N1. Now, in this case, we can see that this field resistance line is greater than the critical resistance for this curve 3. And therefore, if speed of the machine is equal to N2, then the machine will fail to excite and the generator will fail to build up, because the field resistance line is greater than the critical resistance. Now, if the speed is increased, and if it is increased such that this field resistance line for the value of resistance RSH, it is tangent to the OCC. So, for this speed NC, the OCC is such that the field resistance line is tangent to the OCC. In that case, for this speed NC, the generator will just excite, and this speed we call it as critical speed NC. If the speed of machine is less than NC, then the generator will fail to excite. And for proper excitation of field winding, the speed of machine must be greater than this critical speed NC. So, let us see definition of critical speed. Critical speed of a shunt generator is that speed for which the given shunt field resistance represents critical resistance. So, here shunt field resistance is RSH, and this is the line representing shunt field resistance, and it is the critical resistance line for this OCC at which the speed is critical speed, that is NC. Hence, a shunt generator will build up only if it is rotated above its critical speed NC, and it will not build up its voltage if the speed of rotation is less than the critical speed NC. Let us now summarize the essential conditions that must be fulfilled for the buildup of voltage in a self-excited DC shunt generator. So, the first requirement is there must be a residual magnetism in the poles. So, when the field current IF is equal to zero, some residual flux must be there. If it is not there, generator will fail to excite. Then second requirement is this field winding and armature winding must be properly connected according to the direction of rotation. So if these connections are not proper, then the flux produced by field winding will be opposite to the residual flux, and in that case the generator will fail to excite. So for voltage buildup, the flux produced by field winding must aid the residual flux which is already there, then only the machine will excite, otherwise it will fail to excite. And therefore the second essential requirement is connections of armature and field winding must be proper. Then the third requirement is the total resistance of shunt field circuit, including the resistance connected in this shunt field circuit. So total resistance of this shunt field circuit must be less than the critical resistance RC, then only the generator will excite. And the fourth requirement is the speed of rotation should be more than the critical speed NC, otherwise the generator will fail to excite. Now let us solve one example for better understanding. The open circuit characteristic of a DC shunt generator with field resistance of 100 ohm means RSH is equal to 100 ohm and driven at 1000 rpm is as follows. So field current in ampere is given, and the value of generated EMF for corresponding field current is also given. Find open circuit voltage and exciting current, then B, critical resistance, and C, shunt field winding resistance to induce 115 volt on open circuit. So let us solve this problem. So first step is we have to plot the open circuit characteristic. So on the x-axis we have to take field current in ampere, and on y-axis we have to take generated EMF in volt, and we have to plot the open circuit characteristic. So the open circuit characteristic can be plotted like this with the help of these readings. Now we have to determine open circuit voltage and exciting current. Now we have seen that the operating point is the intersection point of the OCC and shunt field resistance line. Now shunt field resistance RSH is equal to 100 ohm. Therefore slope of shunt field resistance line must be 100. So one point on the line will be the point O, that is origin, and second point will be where V is equal to 100 and I is equal to 1. So if we connect these two points, we will get a line representing shunt field resistance, because slope of this line will be equal to 100 and the RSH is also equal to 100. So RSH is 100 ohm, and therefore we can draw a line OA, and slope of line OA must be equal to 100 because RSH is equal to 100 ohm. Now this point of intersection is the open circuit voltage. So for this point of intersection, we can see that the open circuit voltage is 100 volt, and the field current required for this is 1 ampere, and therefore open circuit voltage is 100 volt and exciting current will be 1 ampere. So the first answer is open circuit voltage is equal to 100 volt and exciting current IF is equal to 1 ampere. Now we have to determine the critical resistance. Now to determine the critical resistance, we have to draw a line OC such that the line is tangent to this initial portion of OCC. So if we draw a line tangent to this OCC, then we will get the line OC. Now we have to calculate slope of this line OC. Now for this line we can see that the slope of the line is 115 divided by 0.8. So the slope of line is 115 divided by 0.8, which is equal to 143.75 ohm. And therefore, the value of critical resistance is 143.75 ohm. If shunt field winding resistance is more than this value, the generator will fail to excite. Now, third question is determine shunt field winding resistance to induce 115 volt on open circuit. Means in case of open circuit, the point of intersection must be 115. So this point. So we have to draw a line joining this point and origin. We will get the line OB. So we can draw a line OB such that the point of intersection gives the induced EMF, which is equal to 115 volt. Then slope of this line will represent the value of shunt field resistance. So we can determine the slope from this. This is 0, 0, and this point is 115 and 1.4. So slope will be 115 divided by 1.4. So it is equal to 82.14 ohm. Means if the value of field resistance is 82.14 ohm, then the induced EMF on open circuit will be equal to 115 volt. Thank you. Stay home. Stay safe.